Hi, I'm Pat O'Leary with USDA's Office of Communications, and I'm here with Adam Cline from the USDA National Agricultural Statistics Service. Adam is the Census and Survey Division section head, and he's going to highlight some information about the Census of Agriculture and the upcoming once every 5 year census data release on April 11th. Adam, we've been hearing a lot about the Census of Agriculture pretty regularly over the last couple of years. What should everyone know about the Census of Agriculture?
Well, thanks for having me, Pat. I always appreciate the opportunity to speak about the census. The census actually has a pretty long and interesting history, going back to 1840, when the first census was conducted. It was conducted in conjunction with the decennial census from 1840 until about 1920. After 1920, the Census of Agriculture broke off from the decennial census and was conducted every 4 or 5 years. In 1982, we began the every 5 year cycle we're on now, which is years ending in 2 and 7. The Census of Agriculture allows us to collect more detailed information on certain aspects of the agriculture industry, such as aquaculture and organic and horticulture. We do this with a series of special studies. These are surveys conducted in the in-between years of the 5 year Census of Agriculture.
Adam, where will this data live? Where will we find it?
All the Census of Agriculture data, including 2017 and the historical years, is all available on our website at www.nass.usda.gov.
Beyond being sent to every farmer and rancher in the country, what makes the Census of Agriculture different from other Nass surveys?
Well, the Census of Agriculture allows us to provide data for every county in the nation. It also gives us a glimpse into the demographic makeup of American agriculture and the people that are involved. And it also gives us data on specialty crops and livestock that our annual programs do not collect, such as ginseng and alpacas.
And what do we know about how the data are used?
Census of Ag data will be used by all those who serve farmers in the U.S. Businesses use the data to target certain locations for their facilities that will best serve the farmer. Local governments use the data to target programs and services for its communities. Congress uses the data to help shape farm policy and programs. And finally, the farmers and ranchers themselves use the data to help make better decisions on their own operations.
Will Nass publish all the data you received?
No, unfortunately, we're not able to publish all data. Any item that could potentially identify an individual producer will be suppressed or hidden and noted with a D in the publications.
Adam, what was the national response rate to the census this time?
Well, first I'd like to take the opportunity to thank the American farmers and ranchers that took the time to respond to the 2017 Census of Agriculture. We had a good response rate of about 72%. And even though we do try, we do not expect a response from everyone. Like other statistical agencies, we do have methodology in place to account for a certain level of non-response. And this allows us to continue to provide accurate data.
We're coming up on the April 11th data release date. What's next, and when does the census cycle start all over again?
So as far as 2017 Census of Ag is concerned, yes, we'll release the national, state, and county level data on April 11th, but throughout the year, we'll continue to release data products from the 2017 census, and these include state and county profiles, as well as race, ethnicity, and gender profiles. Currently, we are conducting the Puerto Rico Census of Agriculture, so we're collecting data there now, and in the next few weeks, we will begin collecting data in our other outlying areas, such as Guam and the U.S. Virgin Islands. We're also currently conducting the first two special studies. These are the 2018 Census of Aquaculture and the 2018 Irrigation and Water Management Survey. Meanwhile, we are planning for the next census, which is the 2022 Census of Agriculture. We currently have an area designated on our website for the public to offer comments and suggestions on questionnaire content. And we also have an area for farmers to sign up to be counted. Our goal is to continue to provide comprehensive and useful data to the American public.
You barely have time to catch your breath when the census ends and you start all over again. Well, we'd like to thank Adam Cline from the National Agricultural Statistics Service. Thank you, Adam, for joining us today.
Thank you, Pat.
And next time we'll visit with Ginger Harris with Nass in Kentucky to talk about what's new in the Census of Agriculture. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you then.